Welcome all students in your biology class. I am Sapna Trivedi and we are discuss about health and human health and disease chapter number 8, where we have discussed about bacterial disease, viral disease, protozoan disease and helminthic disease. Okay, hope you understand and you also revise this one. Now this disease, which is a daily, or either we can be say we are exposed with that environment where there is a number of the germs, in the sense of bacteria, in the sense of viral, protozoans. So inside in ourself only, we are having our own defense mechanism. We can develop more better to maintain the hygienic and such a vaccinization program and what. But itself in our from the birth, we are having some defense mechanism. So let us start and understand this defense mechanism for your board examination purpose. Just see student, this topic is a very, very important. This full chapter is a very important, but this topic is a important in direct and indirect, both type of the questions can be come. And we are going to discuss the questions also. The first, we understand what is an immunity. Okay, we are going to discuss about defense mechanism. So immunity, this word, it is a meaning, it is an ability of an organism to resist, okay? Resist means protect or defend itself from the disease. So this is a immunity, okay? We are having in our body two type of the immunity. From the birth, which we are having inside in our body, that is called the innate immunity, okay? That is called innate immunity, okay? It means inborn immunity, which we are get from the our parents, or either we can be say from the birth. That is called the innate immunity. Acquired immunity, okay? Our bodies are exposing to environment, there is a bacteria and viral and other type of such pathogens. So our body is developing against the such pathogen, such antibodies to fight or resist our body. So this is acquired immunity. Acquired immunity again is having two type, active and passive immunity. We are going to discuss with the example, okay? So you will be not going to confuse. Let us start about innate immunity. Okay, as we say, that is meaning, it means inborn, from the birth, inherited. It's from the birth, that it means inherited. We are getting from our parents. Non-specific. What is meaning of this? Non-specific. Meaning of non-specific, we can be say some are the specific bacteria. Okay, suppose a streptococcus, or suppose such are the other that you can be say salmonella. So our body cells is killed specific pathogen. Specific pathogen killed by our specific cell, that is called a specific one. But this is non-specific. Okay, this is just the barrier way, and some are the defensive mechanism, physiological way, they are going to just protect our body. So that is a non-specific one. We are asking our difference between innate immunity and acquired immunity. So that's why I just discuss the meaning of innate immunity. So I hope the second point is clear. Now, accomplished by different barrier. It means this innate immunity is complete by different barrier, which we are get from the birth, or either which we are having in our body. That is called a barrier. Okay. We are going to discuss one by one. There is a physical barrier, physiological barrier, and the cytokinin barrier and cellular barrier. This is the four types of barrier we are going to discuss. I am again repeating, physical barrier, physiological barrier, and then the cellular barrier and the cytokinin. Physical barrier, it means our itself, our body. Got it? We are having a such protecting layer, and such are the having in our body, some are the organ. So this is are called a physical. What do you mean about the physiological? Physiological, it means such production which in our body is produce something, okay, in a physiological way, in the specific chemical process, and that chemical product is our protect our body. Cellular barrier in the sense of, we can be say there is a some special cell in our body like a WBC. So it's a kill pathogen. So that cell is very specific to killing pathogen. That is called a cellular one. And the fourth, which is very, very important, later we are going to discuss in more detail, that is called a cytokine. And cell, which is one infected, but other this infected cell is protect the other non-infected cell. How it is, we are going to discuss. Let me see. So let's discuss physical barrier. Okay, what is come in the physical barrier in example way, they are going to ask. So you have to understand, meaning I explained. So skin is a physical barrier, your skin, okay, it's the protect our other muscle cells, okay, so that is our skin. Mucous membrane of digestive tract, respiratory tract and urogenital tract. So we are having a inside in our body, that is one system, digestive system, respiratory system. So they are having a membrane, and this membrane having a mucus, some sticky substances, okay, and this substance is a covered membrane, and that way it's protect our body. So this is a physical barrier. Note down this, all the things, anytime it can become in the example they are going to ask. So next, innate immunity, that is a physiological barrier. So innate immunity having the such barrier, first physical, second physiological. Physiological, it means product or such chemical product which is defends our body. So what is that one? Some example it is here. Sweat, okay, pasina. How it is, we can be say that is having a such ammonia and salt and water, that way they are just cool down our temperature, and as well as they are killing some other germs from the skin one. Tear, okay, it's protect our eyes one. Some dust particle, if it is come in our eyes, so this tear and the tearing process, we can be said that tear is started, and that way we get our eyes clean. Acid in the stomach, okay, that is a hydrochloric acid, so it's kill pathogens, some are the germs in the stomach one. Saliva, this is in our mouth. Okay, so saliva is also in a little acidic medium, and as well as they having an enzyme, lysozymes enzyme, that way it's a kill some are the germs. Got it? So example you have to learn, cellular barrier. Cellular barrier, the name is very clear, cell, some are special cell like a WBCs. In that WBC, there is having a types one, okay, which you are already discussed, you know about in the 10th standard, and as well as in the 11th standard, there is a human circulatory system where we have discussed about the types of WBC, okay. So you can be go through that one also, the types WBC, that is called a polymorphonuclear leukocyte, okay, and monocyte, this is the name of the cell, and natural killer lymphocyte, that is our special lymphocyte cell. Some are the specific lymph nodes, and that lymph nodes is secrete some are the special antibody, that is called a lymphocytes one, and they are killing the pathogen, okay. Macrophages means killing of the, some are the cell which kill bacteria with the phagocytosis process. Phagocytosis, it means the process where the cell is just going to englobe. This is a WBC suppose, okay, and here is a pathogen, so they englobe this pathogen, okay, or either the germs one. So this engulfing process by the special cell, that process is a phagocytosis, and that cell is called a phagocytose and destroy microbes, okay. I hope you understand this one. If it is any query, you can ask me. Next, and the fourth, this is very, very important. It's a come in a 2 months question and very important one. Okay, so please understand. Cytokinin barrier. What is the meaning of the cytokinin? Suppose I want to explain in that figure diagram, but first you read it. What is that one? This is interferon produced by virus. Okay, infected cells protect non-infected cell. This is called a cytokinin barrier. Let's see how it is. Okay, 1 minute only. So this cytokinin barrier, if you want to understand, you can just please imagine this is a cell. Okay, this is our cell. And we can be say, suppose this cell, okay, this cell, this is, you can be say A, B and C, okay. And this cells, B is infected by a virus, got it. So this virus infected cell, in that time, whenever this cell is infected, some other chemical is produced. And this chemical is come in the membrane, the cell membrane, this way. So this chemical which is infected by the cell, some chemical process is going to start. Okay, so this is the chemical protect the C cell, this is a B cell, or either we can be said a D cell, or either they are just protect the adjacent or nearby cell with the this chemical which is infected by the virus only, and that such a process is going on, and that way that chemical is just cover this cell membrane, okay, which shield bana leta, and that shield of chemical is protect other cell. This process is called interferons, okay, by the specific chemical, and this type of the defense mechanism is called cytokinin. Okay, cyto is mean cell, and kinin a process where the interferon or the some chemical process is going to be produced, so that way other cell is going to protect. This technique we are using in a cancer treatment, interferons one. Okay, later we are going to discuss because cancer is also in your this chapter. So interferon techniques we are this one is helping to cure cancer patients. Okay, let's start the next topic of immunity, that is called acquired immunity. Okay, which we are getting after the birth. Okay, so here some specific point is there, but read NCERT textbook properly, students. Okay, so this is things which we are just be explaining here, or if you are getting from the other also, let's just, but first go to NCERT and with this topic. Acquired immunity, what is that? Not present from the birth, we are acquiring, we are getting after the birth. Okay, when a pathogen attack in our body, it's a pathogen specific, it means a specific bacteria, specific mechanism, or a specific lymphocyte, or either the specific cell is going to produce on the time. Distinguishes diverse types of foreign molecules. Okay, this is a more description of this one. Okay, so it's diverse type of foreign molecule, bacteria, protozoans, or some other type of the things. So this is a distinguished diverse type of foreign molecule. Foreign molecule is also called antigens. Okay, now this acquired immunity is not a directly response when the first time attacking. The best example of the measles you will take sometime when we are just be observe the some person, he just be infected by the measles one. Okay, the severe condition started 1, 2, 3, 4 days, and automatically 5, 6, 7 days is going to come down with this type of the measles disease. Okay, so but we can be sick if it is a person having this disease in one time in one life, the second time chances are very less. Why it is? In this time they are response first time, okay, and our body is responding first time only this pathogen is contacting the body, and our body is produce such specific antibodies. That way we are sick this time, that is a primary response, the first time encounter of the pathogen. So antibody is producing, but in a very slow intensity. So this acquired immunity is having a two way. Primary response, it means first encounter the pathogen, and that time a low intensity, okay, very slow, it will take the time, but in that time they are giving such memory to in our cells, in our pathogen specific our antibodies. And that time the secondary response, so memory of this encounter, okay, so already our body has developed the antibody against the that type of antigen, so it's a very high intensity. The secondary response is also called anamnestic, okay, this is called anamnestic response, okay, and this is a high response or the high intensity way, because already the cell is memorized way, only that time it's going to response, not in the developing and processing process. Now the C, immune response is two type of lymphocyte. Two, it's mean in the time they are producing lymphocyte. Lymphocyte, it's means antibody. Okay. So types of lymphocytes is are having two, B lymphocytes and T lymphocyte. B lymphocyte is also called B cells. T lymphocyte cells is called the T cells also. Okay. Let's see what is the special characteristics of B cells. B cells an army of protein called antibodies. Okay, antibody. Are you understand? Antibody, antigen, foreign material. Antibody, our defense cells. So this is an army of protein called antibodies. That is the structure of B cells, which we are going to discuss afterwards. T cells help B cells to produce antibody. It means this is a main cell and this is a helper cells. So helping into help B cell to produces antibodies. Okay. Now this response in our body, we will see in which organ, which cell, which specific part is going to response with this way. Okay. So this acquired response is a two way, two types. Okay, our body, our cells is responding in two way. What is that one? This is again, I just we say this is a full topic, is so important in your 2 marks, 3 marks question, as well as in between 1 marks question specifically. So two types of acquired response is the first humoral immune response. Okay, this word humoral, it means the humor. And this meaning is called fluid, liquid. So what is in the liquid in our body? What is the things is in our body which is in a liquid form? That is definitely blood and the lymph. So humoral immune response, or other name, antibody mediated immunity. Okay, what is the antibody? Antibody mediated immunity. Where we are just get this response in our blood and lymph. What next? Cell mediated immune response. It means specific cells. It's a short form CMI. This is in your 1 mark question. Is it important? So the cell mediated immunity, that is called a T lymphocyte, a special T lymphocyte. This T lymphocyte, which is a help to produce the B main cells of the antibody, what is that exactly, in what time it is that exactly respond? When the time of the organ transplant. So this is a cells is just we identified our own cells and other cells, that is called a non-self cells. So it is a responsible for graft. Okay. Rejection in organ transplant, kidney transplant or any other type of the things in the body, that time this one is a response. And ability to difference self and non-self cells. This is a very important part, okay? Which cell is responsible for a rejection of an organ transplant? So you can just write down the T lymphocyte. It means CMI, cell mediated immune response. Next is a structure of antibody. This is again very easy to understand. Got it? And 3 marks if you want to score it. So just learn the proper way, you will get this antibody structure.